got a magical ring, magical wand. Phew.
I must apologize, but I can carry no more. I have set your item upon the ground.
Have to do one at a time. I can't identify it without taking the scroll out. Alright, let's just take these then. It's another wand of cloud kill. This one with 10 charges. Don't use cloud kill that often. Just have to remember not to sell it. Oh, wait. Wand of lightning. 10 charges. And there's more stuff too. Okay. This is another wand of fire. 10 charges. Put that in there. An unidentified rod, an unidentified ring. You take this wand with one charge left, because I have to take out some scrolls of identify. Okay. Okay. I never even found a rod before, I don't think. In either the first Baldur's Gate or Siege of Dragonspear. I'm not sure, but definitely don't remember finding a wand. I mean a rod. Rods are... found plenty of wands. Rods are about 3 feet long and as thick as your thumb. They are normally found in cases or similar storage places. Rods can be fashioned from metal, wood, ivory, or bone. They can be plain or decorated and carved, tipped, or not. Rods are powered by charges unless noted otherwise in the description of a particular rod. Each time the rod is used, one or more charge may be expended. Would use more than one charge at once? Huh. Not identifying. Rod of Terror. Whoa. When activated, this rod may be used as a staff plus 3. Any creature hit by the wand must make a saving throw versus spell or flee in terror, fearing the wielder as if he or she were a flesh-eating demon from the abyss. There is a drawback to using this rod, however. Each time the rod is used, there is a 20% chance that the wielder loses 1 point of charisma permanently. Oh, wow. That's no good. Okay, save versus spell at plus 4 or flee in terror for 4 rounds. 20% chance per use of the wielder losing 1 point of charisma permanently. Otherwise, it's stack all plus 3 and is 1d6 plus 3 crushing. I'm not sure who would be best able to use this. I mean, who has a lot of charisma? Nalia's not bad. I'm not taking it. I'm not going to lower my charisma. Yoshimo? He's got 18. It's boosted. Normally isn't that much. Because of this? No. What's giving him the charisma? This. Ring of Human Influence. Huh. That's good. Because no matter what happens, the charisma's 18. I didn't realize they even had the charm person charge in there. So that this could be a good, you know, stopgap to stopping the effects of the Rod of Terror. Wear that ring. And no matter what, your charisma will be 18, right? I'm assuming. That's what it says. Charisma 18. So I guess even if you have one charisma, it would make it 18. Wow. Wow, that's the Lich? He's huge. Was that the pit fiend?
Every hamster has his day.
Should we just leave? I mean, we can't really hold much more unless I stick some stuff in the bag of holding. Oh, I didn't do this one yet. Ugh. Style the rod. I'm gonna put the rod in here for now. Ring. Identify. Ring of Invisibility, Sand Thief's Ring. Held by a master thief for the better part of a generation, this ring was put to bold use in the markets of Waterdeep. Working a crowd in broad daylight, the rogue would steal countless numbers of purses from nobles, replacing them with bags of sand so the theft would go unnoticed. Almost like a criminal version of Indiana Jones, right? His identity was never known, but the name Sand Thief was cursed loudly in its stead. It is rumored he retired and now lives among the nobles he used to rob. Invisibility once per day, affecting the wearer, of course, only lasting for 12 hours. That's sweet. Oop. Well, that's a charm in Earth Elemental.
I'm not accustomed to such loads. I've had to drop something.
She said load. Huh. Keep key. Oh, for the key for Nalia's. Keep. Alright, I'll let you have it for now anyway. I'm afraid if I leave, we're not being able to get the stuff in here. Well,
you require my counsel, yes? You're right behind me, right?
Well, there's nothing in there.
Yes, a simple matter.
Interesting.
Where shall I display my skill in?
Very well. Hiya.
Okay. A scroll of carrion summons and a magical longsword. Do you have any room? You do. Level 6. Huh. Surprised it's not necromancy spell. 7 rounds plus a round per level, so quite a few rounds for me. 18, I guess? Am I level 11? Level 12.
What is it?
So, yeah, 19 rounds. Casting time 9. There are 2 parts to this spell. First, a small portal opens and summons 1d2, meaning 1 or 2, carrion crawlers to a point designated by the wizard. Second, the magic mutates the carrion crawlers into larger, more vicious versions of themselves. I have fought those mutated carrion crawlers. I remember that. The wizard now has control over these creatures until they are slain, and the spell's duration expires. There is a 35% chance that 2 carrion crawlers will be summoned instead of 1. 1d2. I mean, it's a 1d2. Means you roll 1 or 2. So it should be 50% chance that they're summoned, because then you get 2 on the roll of d2. I don't know. That's interesting, though. I can learn it to get rid of the spell. Or the scroll, rather. Get room in inventory. Oh, I don't even have it here. Okay. It has been copied. And then I'll take this. Stick another out. I knew there was a reason I saved all these scrolls. Sunblade, Daystar, plus 2. Whether created specifically for use in the service of Torm or appropriated at some point in the long history of the Church, Paladins of the Loyal Fury have made good use of Daystar in their battles against evil undead. Through magic or blessing, it is empowered with the Sunray, a force of pure life energy so potent it slays both living and unliving. So we can cast Sunray once per day. So I guess this is the details of Sunray. 3d6, save versus spell or be blinded for one turn. Undead take an additional 1d6 points of damage per level of caster, or in this case, swordswoman. Save versus spell or be destroyed. I guess no matter what, they take an additional 1d6, and then they also have to save versus spell. Thaco is plus 2, plus 4 versus evil creatures. 1 damage, 1d2, 1d8 plus 2 plus 4 versus evil creatures does double damage against undead. That's awesome.
I have had to drop what you gave me. I have only 2 arms and no more space.
Can he use it? It's not glowing up like he should. One-handed. He can use it. Daystar plus 2. Yes, that goes plus 2. Yeah, it's even better. Okay. Do I have room? Okay, I can put this in here. Okay.
If memory serves, Yokata.
Okay.
Armored, sharpened, and the bigger they are, the hard live by the sword. Live a good long time.
So this guy here, Grown Canner, had no idea. There's a lich resting just in a secret hidden passage.
Stand back for justice!
Alright, there's no temple here. We need to raise them. Yeah, it was returned into 4 episodes. Guess it took me a little while to defeat them. Guess the temple district.
See battle bow, run bow, run.
Was Lathander? No. Maybe Lathander can help us. I think it's Helm who won't until we finish their quests. Really, really need to raise one person, Jahira, and then she can raise Airy. Oh, last time I went in here, there was nobody here. Except these.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
Except these morning knights, and they don't. They don't provide temple services. Nobody here.
Disney. Nothing dangerous, I would hope.
Do I dare? I took a sunstone gem. A lynx eye gem. History of Om, do not need. 99 gold, sure. History of Kalim Shan, do not need. Magical wand of fear. How much space do I have? Just one. Huh. Oh, it's a wand of monster summoning. That's right, it's not red. Oh, three charges only.
I'm red. I can dance on the head of a pin as well.
A statuette of Lathander and a sunstone gem. I'm gonna be really upset if they find this stuff missing. A beautiful depiction of the Morning Lord. The statue is primarily silver, adorned with sunstones and emeralds. I don't suppose I can go in there. No, okay. Alright. Last time there were guards standing here, weren't there?
Bad kicking, for goodness!
Now, Talos, we stole something from there.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
I don't know if they're going to know it's us that took it. Hopefully not. If so, we're getting the hell out of there. I think they were the ones that provided us services last time.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
That was it. It's 6 p.m. I don't see anybody in here. Unless she's hanging out in here again. Still asleep. Yeah, it doesn't help us. Alright.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
We have to raise them, mister. I don't know if they do that in the... I don't think so. In the most radiant order, etc.
Yes, sir.
By Torm, not again. Patience, my lady. This could be amusing, Sir Cadril says. Well, get on with it then. Yes, okay. Garrick again. Sarando says, Lady Erlana, I am bedazzled by your beauty and awestruck by your nobility. What I would not do to spend an evening in your arms. Lady Erlana, I am bedazzled by your beauty and yawnstruck by your nobility. What I would not to do spend an evening in your barns. Arms, fool! Arms! Arms, fool! I meant arms. Yes, your arms. Sir Cadril snorts and chuckles. Did you now, good sir? What makes you think you be worthy to spend an evening in my arms? Well, it's easy. Sarando whispering. I can never truly be worthy of a true lady of virtue, my love. I only desire that you could see past my faults and give me a chance. Garrick whispers. Why not tell her how handsome and studly I am, Sarando? Oh, get over yourself, boy. I can never truly be worthy of a blue lady of virtue, my love. I only desire you that you see past my faults and give me pants. Give you pants, good sir? Are you perchance missing a pair? Sir Cadril says, well, perhaps the gnome fellow standing behind our good Garrick has the answer to that. What say you, Sir Gnome? Eek! Discovered! Run for it, boy! Well, they're running in there. Hi.
Hello there.
Garrick be an amusing man, but he'll hardly take my heart. For a bard, he seems to have a hesitant and awkward grasp of courtly words.
I welcome you with outstretched hand.
It is quite amusing to watch Garrick perform these endeavors in his efforts to win the lady's heart. I cannot wait to see what he does next. Yeah. Rather amusing, isn't it? Well, we still have to raise our party members. Trying to think. Where did we go? The one in the slums was not helpful. He just stood there. We couldn't talk to him. The docks. Oh, Temple of Ogma, maybe? It'd be right there.
Stand back for justice!
It's probably faster to walk this way. We'll raise Jahira, and she'll raise Aerie. I'm still amazed that we survived that lich. Maybe the elemental lich is tougher because that one creamed us. Well, maybe we're just lucky, either one. One side commoner. Hail.
Don't teach my counselor to suck eggs!
What they said, what he said before. I just figured now that we, I think we defeated that other thieves guild, that he'd have something different to say. See your services.
Nature's servant awaits.
Nature's servant shall now heal. Minsk at 98 hit points now, I just noticed that.
See, battle bow! Run, bow, run!
Alright, back to the Sea Bounty's Tavern.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
We killed a lich! And we got lots of awesome stuff. It's Speaking of which, I always forget to give them back their stuff. I think that might be Ares. Very talented, she puts all this stuff on as we're running around.
Swords, not words! But kicking for goodness!
Oh wait, before we do anything...
I await your need.
Airy?
A lot more exciting than any circus.
What, coming back from the dead? Guess it can be. Okay. Oops. Give that to the wrong person. Was she using the arc leather? No, she can't wear it. She can. Oh, wizard spell's disabled, that's why I don't use it. Right, well, here, take that. Because she was just raised, I guess. Who's wizard spells?
Just ask, and I'll do it.
I mean, I think it would be from...
What?
Putting on the orc leather, but I guess that's what we did. Okay.
Yes?
I thought I put something in here that had like one charge or something. Well, it's not like she can
fine
handle it right now.
It's a cold and dreary day when this Demcourt extend a bit of hospitality to his guests. Come, enter and be welcome at the Sea's Bounty.
You talk a lot.
You need something?
Alright, she's better now.
Where can I be of most use?
Oh, here it is. Take this stuff with one charge. Hopefully use it up. This is going to go in the bag of holding. Anything else? Cloud kill. Pretty sure this was hers. Alright. And we're all better, just like that.
Minsk, where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Is that your way of trying to threaten me? Oh, the messenger. I think he's trying to get through to Sapphire.
Yes, I am willing.
You're trying to get to Nalia?
What such menial tasks?
Oh. He was. Miss Nalia? Miss Nalia Diarnese? Yes, that is my name. What can I do for you, son? You call him son like that? I have a message for you, Miss Nalia, from the residents of the Diarnese estate. I must get an imprint of your signet ring to prove I found you. Well, she doesn't have her signet ring on her. Of course, you have done well. Thank you, Miss Nalia. Though I do hate to be the bearer of somber news, here's your message. Safe travels to you. Well, I guess he knows what the message contains. Let's see what this says then, shall we? Oh my. I must go to the graveyard district in Athcatla at once. All other concerns must wait. I'm sorry, but I must insist upon this. What is your concern? It must be quite grave, get it, to cause you such grief. You are more correct than you might have wished, but I forgive your ignorance. The message is about my father's funeral. I must go to the graveyard district. No, we're not doing anything else, and I was kind of planning on going there. It's the only district we haven't seen. Then we shall go as soon as mortally possible. I would not dream of letting you miss it. Thank you. I do appreciate this. It seems I owe you another debt of gratitude. That's not part of that. A messenger arrived telling Nalia that she must go to the graveyard district in Athcatla as soon as possible to attend her father's funeral. I have agreed to accompany her. Okay.
Everett, jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
I have no idea what that guy was trying to achieve. Well, he was trying to get to Nalia, but he was just standing there and kind of like kneeling up and down over and over. It was quite odd.
Good to see a like-minded friend to be.
At them, lads! We'll not let these worthless skags take away our night. What? Arcanus Gath? Stand ye well back from the battle, fool. You are not involved in this.
Beg for death, and I'll make it quick.
Okay. Was Arcanus Gath a vampire? or Shadow Thief.
How can- Of course.
I go.
Alright.
Am I needed?
Yes?
Well, she's got haste. She's got protection from evil. Apparently we can use spells now. I wasn't even going. I was just going to go to the edge of this district. But more stuff keeps happening.
It is about time.
No.
Speak your mind.
What? Yes?
Please, let me help.
I'll help however I can.
I don't like cities much. They're built on the backs of the unfortunate.
Okay. I guess he's from the Shadow Thieves, because he's... I don't know how much... How many hit points these, like how injured they are. There's a rat just watching the fight.
Good to see a like-minded friend to be.
Arcanus Gath says, one less cadre of Nightcrawlers to pester our membership. Hell, if this is the best they can do, we Shadow Thieves will not have a competing guild for long. Back to the guild to bandage and prepare for another day. We'll hunt again when the moon is bright. Oh, they ran in there.
All right.
Armored, live by the sword.
For the glory of
live
all.
A good long time.
He ran in here. So I was down by the docks the other day, right? Guard captain says, watching one of them big barges from Kalimport unload, and you know what I sees? What? What'd you see? I sees them taking people off their ship. Slaves, of course. So I tells them they needs a license, right? And of course they... Hey. Hey, are you still here? We told you to get lost. Beat it, woman. Alright, we're not still here. We're just here again.
Stand back for justice!
Let's
see
go.
Battle bow. Run, bow, run!
Kind of wasted some buffs here. But... Who's that? Althea?
Pleasure to meet you.
Hello there, good gentleman. My name is Althea. Are you looking for a bit of company, perhaps? I'd rather ask you a question or two if I could. Oh, if that is what you wish, my lord, I have no objections. I've heard rumors of thieves everywhere here in the docks. What do you know about that? I know little about the thieves, my lord. They be all over the district, and the other women say you must never work for Mavar if you value your skin. She was right. Mavar is dead. You know, you seem a woman of class, Althea. How is it you came to this life on the streets? Is it that obvious? I have never done this before. I am so ashamed. But father is dead and mother cannot feed us. I have to do something. Here then, child, take these 50 gold pieces. I can afford it, and I trust it will tide you over a short while. Oh, but you are too kind. Sir, I guess talking to Minsk. Lathander's blessing upon you. Mother shall be ever so happy. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Okay. Don't be shy. Step right up. Okay, so next episode, guys, finally, the Graveyard District. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.